So hi all aspirants, welcome to today's session. Today is 2nd November 2020. So we have lots of news to cover today. And the front page, we have GST inflows crores of 1 lakh rupees crore in October. This comes as actually a clear sign of recovery, but experts voice caution about the sustainability of trend, that is how we are able to garner lots of revenue for ourselves, especially in this corona pandemic issues. And we were already in a crisis of economic problems. So how far this is true and how far we are able to recover from this? So your first question is that how was this possible? How we are able to incur lots of inflow or surplus amount of revenue? So that will be your first questions. And here it's written that Hizbul chief killed in encounter in Jammu and Kashmir. That is, since the Article 370 was removed, that is a special provision for the Jammu and Kashmir people. So since that was removed, lots of people agitating for this, especially the local ones, especially the people belonging to these places. So here, and one of the biggest problem was that when these special provisions was taken care of, the Jammu and Kashmir, this was demarcated and divided on the basis of two units or two union territories. So this was actually a main problem for these people. And one thing is that this Hizbul gang or this terrorist gang, this is not the first time the leader of this party or this function or this faction is being killed. There were lots of many times in which these leaders of the terrorist group of Hizbul was murdered and killed, shot dead by these soldiers. So now at present, the outfit is now leaderless. So let's see what's going to happen next, and if they're going to elect or select a new leader for themselves, and if they're again going with the terrorists and terrorist attacks. So let's wait and watch. And here it's written that Modi mocks Tejaswi Rahul as double Yuvraj. So yes, this is pertinent to your elections. That is, I told you yesterday itself. So since the elections are coming up, so expect lots of news and lots of information regarding all these, wherein one political party or one political leader will be putting lots of blame on the other, and the other political party will be throwing blame on the other, and the other political party will come with the reverence or in sort of like clarifications. So we're going to find lots of news like that. I'm just asking you to just read through it, but do not make notes over it. And here, after UP, Haryana government also moves on the law against the love jihad. That is, the Yogi already has taken into considerations of the love jihad. Love jihad is actually a concept or a term in which people of two intercastes or people of two religions or two faith, they come in together and they fall in love and they get married. The problem is that one person will convert religion to the other. So they are coming with a claim that people from the Muslim religion are doing all this love jihad. But I personally, I do not feel or believe in this concept. I don't think people marry for religion. People marry for love, and people could have their own opinions and allegations. And I don't believe that love jihad was a term coined by Muslim people. I think it was coined by anti-Muslim people. And yes, this is local visitors fill tourist space in Kaziranga. That is I'm not just talking about a wildlife sanctuary or a wildlife museum or, just one pertinent aspect. Since we are, learning to live with corona pandemic, we have to understand that we cannot put a stop in this corona pandemic. We are trying to curb the corona pandemic, but we have to live with it. We have to learn to live with it, especially keeping into considerations of the safety precautions. That is social distancing, face mask and sanitizers and hand gloves. Everything will be taken care of. The reason is that we cannot, let the economy suffer because of that. Not just the economy, the tourist sector. There are lots of sectors and services. They are suffering and they are in a crisis because of the corona pandemic. So we have learned to live with the corona. And these are the city-based news. So just read through it, or you could just watch your local regional news channels and read or understand or make notes on your regional news only if it's pertinent or important with respect to your national news. So if not, then just read through it or just watch your regional news channels. That will be more than enough. And yes, Baroda bipole, a battle of prestige. This, yes, again with related to your elections and all these things. So just read it. And one problem with elections is that one day we'll be finding two political parties loggerheads with each other. Next day we come to know that these two parties are going for a coalition government. So we don't know what's going to happen. I think we should just wait for till the nominations are being filed out. And when the nominations are being filled, at least we'll have a general idea that who's with who and who's not with him and who's against each other. And yes, again, this page is very much important. Your education plus, that is one thing about your civil service, is that not just reading your current affairs or your static notes wouldn't be suffice for your civil service preparations. You should also read non-fictions on articles, which is very much important, relevant to your society and social structure. That is, you know, everything. One thing is that if you have seen a cheerleading squad, that is, once they are preparing or once they are rehearsing for your cheerleading, what they do is that they will be having their own routines, certain combinations or sequences of dance moves they'll be having, they'll practice that, and once they go for the event, what they do is that depending upon the situations, they'll improvise and they'll do a dance routine or cheerleading routine depending on the situations. So my request will be that sure enough, you're gonna have lots of questions, you will be given out lots of questions, but more than that, have a combinations of questions which are common for all the times. That is, every year they're going to ask certain questions, and they are common questions. The first one is related to your education, and the others will be your gender issues, financial literacy, quality healthcare, environmental issues, animal welfare. Your quality healthcare, yes, since we are going through this pandemic situation, we are going to have lots of questions and lot of variants of questions related to your healthcare facilities and all. And the other type of questions will be, related to your environment, that is the environmental crisis, and the globalization is an important question. So make certain essays and certain notes on these common type of questions, and when they ask you different forms or different versions of such questions, you could make minute changes according to that, modify it according to the question, stick with the question. Since you have already collected certain information and facts and figures for such questions, it will be so much easier. And your wealth of opportunity, yes, also read through it. Once you read, the thing is that it will widen your perspective and it will add on lots of information to yourself. And the other question that I would like to ask you for making essay is that we have lots of government funded scholarships. That is, since India, our literacy rate and the higher education rate is very much low. For those reasons, for curbing those reasons, we have lots of scholarships initiated by the central government and the state governments, and many tribunals are also there. So my question for your essay will be that how far they are predictable, or how far they are feasible, and how far they are fulfilling the essential purpose of these scholarships, and how far they are able to remove the disparity. That is, for some people or for some students, education is accessible, and for some students, education is not accessible. So just find out that and write an essay on it, on scholarship, and that is the government funded scholarships and all. And the next question, the next essay, signs of easing. Yes, this is regarding your corona pandemic. That is, there is actually a signs of easing. That is, all the test numbers, all these numbers, all these corona infected patients are coming down, but we don't know for sure. That is, one reason could be genuinely the numbers coming down. The other reason could be that the test numbers or the amount of tests we conducted, that coming down. So your next question will be that how the absence of evidence is not the evidence of absence. That is related to your corona pandemic. And will that pose a serious threat to our nation? Will that pose a serious threat to the future? Write a short note on that. And here, shifting the trajectory of India's foreign policy. This is with regarding your India-US 2+2 ministerial dialogue. And one thing I would like to say is that you could get lots of mentorship and lots of support from the others and other mentors. But one thing about civil services with regard to other competitive exams is that you yourself have to put in lots of effort. That is, nobody else could prepare for you. So my request will be that try to find out lots of information about it and find what happened during this 2+2 ministerial dialogue, and what was it, what was the bilateral relations, and what is the history of this India-US bilateral relations. Have a complete conceptual understanding. You could just make a flowchart. I'm not asking you to write an essay. You write an essay, very good, but more than that, just write a pictorial or representations or schematic representations in a way that you will have a certain clarity of all these things and all. And Kamala moment in India America politics, yes. And one thing is that not just India going through this election phase, even the other nations such as US and America is also going through the election phase. And over here it's written that for China, a lose-lose election. That is, one thing that we have to understand is that for India it's prime minister, for America it's president. That is, each president or prime minister will be having their own interest and their own interest for the bilateral relations. And I think Prime Minister Modi's and Donald Trump's relations are very good in terms of bilateral relations. But the problem is that when these two relations are very strong, it will affect the other's relation with the other nation as well. So that is how come two nations' friendship will adversely affect enmity with the other nation. So just have an understanding of it. Whenever you read it, have an analytical review it. That is, do not just read through it. Just ask yourself why and how, what is it? Why they are doing this and how come such things are happening? So whenever you're reading, have an analytical course of it and try to have a different meaning. That is reading in between the lines that why all these things are happening, why all these dilemmas are there. So in those formats and queries and complaints, Manusmriti is being rejected by the South Indians, especially the Tamilians. The reason is that Manusmriti is lots of, you know, for pro-untouchability in a way that they are, the Manusmriti is totally encouraging all these disparity between these castes and, you know, the way of ill-treating of the women and the lower class strata. So these Tamil Nadu people, what they are trying to say is that they are totally rejecting the Manusmriti. So just take an account on that. And this person, that is Mr. Paneerselvam, is asking that where did you find such lines in Manusmriti? Are they precisely being written? And he's actually questioning them that where do you get this idea that all these ill treatment of women and all these caste disparity is being written in Manusmriti? And lagging behind this with respect to your corona pandemic and the healthcare facilities that are being provided by each state. And here again, these political related, the election campaigns, all these news are there. And here, youth set himself ablaze near Telangana BJP office. That is, a BJP person was arrested. And for those agitation, one person, he set himself on fire. And luckily, he didn't die. He was taken to a hospital nearby. And let's see, we'll wait for a few days if that will be okay or not. And yes, these are the Hizbul chief killed in encounter in Jammu and Kashmir. Modi mocks Tejasvi, Rahul as double Yuvraj. So these are the follow-up news that we saw on the front page. And Binish complains of uneasiness and hospitalized. That is, Binish Kodiyeri, the son of the famous politician Kodiyeri Balakrishnan. He was taken into custody by the ED, that is the enforcement director, over lots of allegations were there. One is the money laundering and all. So, and all of a sudden, when he was taken under the custody, he said he complained of certain uneasiness and queasiness. So he was hospitalized. Here it's written that a mother and two children, they were found dead in Dublin. And we don't know for the reasons and what kind of death that was. We have to find out in coming days. And case positivity rate declined in October. Yes. So, you know, just have a follow-up understanding or idea for these coronaviruses. That is, when was the peak time and when it declined and which states or which places are coming in front with rates or considerations of the recovery rate and all. So just read through it, all the relations or the information connected to the coronavirus. And yes, oh yeah, that's what I said. Tejasvi confronts PM Modi on the 2014 poll promise. That is, one person, one political leader will be, you know, raising lots of allegation towards the other person, and the other person come with lots of counter attacks and all. So yes, we are going to find lots of news. So my request will be that do not waste your time in all these unnecessary news. Just read through it. It will give you lots of clarity, but do not make notes and do not waste your time for these election related news where these people, you know, alleging one political party and one political party coming with lots of, you know, clarifications for the other. And active cases are falling. That is your corona pandemic. The active cases for the corona infection is being falling down. And banks told to pay back interest on interest. That is the compound interest being initiated by the banks. This is RBI's request to the banks. That is, if you have taken the compound interest, just give that back to all these people. And that is actually a very good thing because of the corona pandemic, lots of people are being jobless and lots of people they don't have the money and they are going through an economical crisis. So this will be a big relief, a huge relief to everyone. And thank you so much, RBI. And here it's written that three new Rafael jets to fly non-stop from France to India. That is, we are going to get three and we already have to get 36 jets in total. And by the end of 2021, we'll be getting the first squadron and of the jets. And by 2023, second end of 2023, we'll be getting the rest of the jets too. So yes, we're going to get three of it now. and file FIRs for cyber crime. That is, we are going, since a lot many people are staying inside the house because of you know, this same corona pandemic issues, I think I'll have to write corona pandemic for all the news, because it's all related and it's so continuous for all the issues. That is, again, I'm going to quote the same phrase, that is, because of corona pandemic, lot many people are jobless, and some people, they are in the house, that is, work from home students and aspirants, they are studying from home, and work from home employees are there. And for those reasons, the use or the usage of these mobile phones and then the facilities will be at high, and for those reasons also the cyber crimes will be high. But the problem is that almost 2 lakh complaints were received on national portal, but only 5,000 cases were registered. And Epiphany is on Instagram, and one request I would like to make for everyone is that, yes, we have to read all these current and static informations for your civil services, but one thing is that, you know, just read through all these non-fiction articles, and I think your Yojana will be very good. And also Yojana is also current affairs. I'm saying is that something related to your civil services, but they are not but they kind of like an articles or write-ups, and all these, yes, fashion related and all. So when you read it, you will have a general understanding. It will, you know, just widen your perspective and your spectrum. So read through all these less important news as well. I'm not saying your election news, but these are also important, because, you know, they widens your perspective. And see over here, Modi with Trump, and they'll be having their own interests, in the sense that some prime ministers will be with some political parties of some states and nations. And treat yourself with healthy options. Read also such articles and such write-ups, because they are important, and when you read it, you will have lots of opinions and clarity on certain issues, social issues and certain problems that are already being here in India, and getting it right step by step. And yes, and that's it for today's news. And I really hope that I was able to convey myself to everyone. And if I wasn't, you do let me know that in the comment section. I think I gave few questions, about 3 to 4 or 5 questions if I remember. And you could either make an essay and mail it to me, or just WhatsApp me. Whichever way, I'll review it. I'll just love to review your answers. And that's it for today's episode. And if you have any doubts or any queries regarding the same, do let me know that in the comment section. So thank you so much.